Hey, how's it going? Dave2D here. So Nvidia recently announced their GeForce RTX lineup, some hardware for desktop gaming that looks honestly quite interesting. But I wanted to talk about how that whole GeForce RTX lineup translates into hardware for laptops. And where do we begin? Okay, let's kind of talk about performance first. Normally, at any kind of like announcement of hardware, especially with Nvidia, they will kind of showcase the new hardware and then compare it to the old hardware and give you some really hard facts, like, you know, it's 8% better, 10% better, 20% better, whatever it is. It's usually a snooze fest, but by the end of the presentation, the audience kind of says, hey, I have a general understanding of how much better the new product is compared to the old product. But they didn't do that this year because GeForce RTX is kind of it's a different beast. It's kind of like a reconceptualization of what gaming hardware is. Instead of kind of using teraflops and measuring it through that kind of like traditional measurement, they're using a new type of metric that focuses on ray tracing capabilities. And it's something that the older generation of cards, like the 10 series or earlier, were just terrible at. So it's no surprise that the RTX series is so much better at this particular metric. But if you look at the actual utility of RTX, like if you look at the actual usability of ray tracing and all of the kind of cool stuff that comes with it, it's not for now, it's for the future. And if you look at games like right now, I don't think it'll be as substantial as we might hope, because yeah, you're getting more CUDA cores, you're getting more efficient hardware, you're getting faster RAM, but the marketing math just doesn't check out. That performance bump that they're claiming is really catered towards ray tracing operations, which is great and everything, but in 2018 and even 2019, that's not the real metric that I think we should be looking at when it comes to gaming performance. So when it comes to laptops, yeah, RTX is gonna be nice, but I don't think it'll be like, it's not gonna be a massive jump. That's what I'm saying. The other thing I wanna talk about is wattage. So if you look at the numbers, RTX GPUs draw a lot of wattage. That 2080 is pulling like 215 watts, which is quite a bit more than last year's 1080. And when you shrink it down into like a laptop version or even a Max Q version, you're gonna have a tough time cooling something like that, even in a thick boy like this. So realistically speaking, we're looking at the 2060s or the 2050s to be able to fit into like a more traditional gaming laptop chassis. Those probably won't come out until the very end of this year or maybe early 2019. Now, the last thing I wanna talk about is just kind of the direction of this whole RTX hardware. So in the laptop industry, I said this last year, the whole shift of mobile gaming has been towards like faster and smoother screens. And like we saw this year, more laptop companies are putting 120 hertz screens, 144 hertz screens into their devices. Even entry-level gaming laptops have faster screens than they did a couple years ago, which is great. But this whole RTX stuff is focused on image quality. They're so focused on like that hyper-realistic look, which is awesome. Like I appreciate what they're going for, but in this current generation of mobile hardware, it doesn't fit that flow of hardware. Like we're looking at demos with incredible visuals, but you take a huge hit on frame rate. So we're able to hit that real time ray trace look. We're talking 60 frames per second, 1080p, which is still really impressive, but it just isn't how I play my games right now. Right now, if you have good hardware, I like to go for high frame rate, really smooth visuals, and not worry so much about image quality, because when you're playing, you're just like focused on the, at least just for the games that I play. So I don't know. RTX is cool, and I think in the future it's gonna be like really, really cool, the whole ray tracing stuff, and as developers pick up on it. But right now, if you're looking at a gaming laptop, RTX is neat, but it's not that neat. Okay, overall thoughts. If you're interested in buying a laptop right now in fall of 2018 or kind of late 2018, I say go for it. You don't have to wait for RTX. I don't think that enough games will take advantage of the whole ray tracing stuff. And I also don't think that the performance bump from the 10 series to the kind of RTX 20 series will be that big, especially in laptops. But yeah, especially because there's so many sales right now, Nvidia's trying to kind of push their 10 series hardware off the shelves and you're getting better pricing and stuff. I'll link some below, but because of back to school sales and some newly announced hardware, you get some really good pricing on some powerful laptops. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time.